Joseph was an old man and an old man was he. When he married Mary, the Lamb of Galilee.
Don't just stand there, do something, I've been told. When I had the temerity to ask what, there was no answer. Or sometimes, well, I don't know, just do something. Well, most of us like to feel as though we're being useful. We occupy ourselves with this or that and hope there's been some point to it. But what about those times when we can do absolutely nothing? We just have to stand there and accept what happens. We're not very good at that, or I should say I'm not very good at that, since I can't really speak for you. There have been a number of times when I felt like a spare part, and just had to stand around and wait and see what happens. Most of us have had that experience one way or another. It seems to me, in the way that the Christmas story is told, to be one person who does a lot of standing around and observing, waiting and watching, wondering perhaps how they can make themselves useful, but not quite managing it somehow. In many nativity plays, Joseph features as the silent member of the cast, and in some he's hardly acknowledged at all. His primary role is just to be there to complete the tableau effect for the final picture. The silent observer with what appears to be a limited role in the events. And yet in Matthew's Gospel, he takes a more prominent role in the preparation. Well, I suppose we know something of Matthew's perception of Joseph's roots, for he does kind of, you know, who do you think you are list, a family tree going back to Abraham for Jesus, and of course Joseph therefore features. The angel appears to him and the name Jesus is given to him for Mary's child. It is Joseph that takes the child and Mary to Egypt for safety and to escape from Herod, who was bringing destruction and a bloody massacre to the families of Bethlehem. In some major scenes, well, I've noted that Joseph is nowhere to be seen. Well, there's Mary and there's Jesus at the centre with the animals and shepherds and kings marking the fringes, but the narrative for some finds no place for Joseph. Each of the various characters at the manger seem to have a role. Shepherds have come with excited stories of angels, light and a great heavenly chorus telling of the wonderful things that God has done in Bethlehem. Strangers from the east eventually find their way with their royal gifts. And it seems that Mary is the one who interacts with them, for she is the one who is said by Luke to store all these things up in her heart. Joseph is the one who just stands there, seemingly saying nothing, doing nothing, just looking on. Do you think he would have been as passive as it seems to suggest by the lack of any record of involvement in the birth? After all, it's not even as though it was his child. This passive observer is perhaps how many of us have felt this Christmas time. We've not really managed to engage with it for one reason or another. It has happened around us rather than with us. Now, before we go on a guilt trip about that, perhaps we need to listen to the carol that says, Venite adoremus. Joseph is perhaps not being as passive as we think. Oh, come, let us adore him. A phrase perhaps captured from the Book of Common Prayer, or even an echo of Psalm 95, where it reads, O come, let us sing to the Lord, and used by the writer of Adeste Fidelis, O come, all ye faithful, in the late 18th century. Was that what Joseph was doing? Notice that the writer does not say, O come, let us serve him, or come, let us strive for him, or live for him, or even die for him. Perhaps that'll come later, in God's good time, but on this night, on this place, and at this moment, the phrase is, O come, let us adore him. And it is most appropriate. This is where we have to start. We may not have heard the heavenly hosts or entered in with the royal train as the magi bring their gifts, but we can enter into this moment of adoration and worship. I think, like Joseph, we should be there. He may well have been stunned by all that had happened around him and to him and to Mary. He may have felt inadequate in the situation as the carpenter of Nazareth, caught up in the drama of God's activity. But he stands and waits to act in those moments he can. Meanwhile, he adores. He worships. He cannot be excluded from the manger scene because that adoration and worship is as essential to that moment as the shepherds from the fields or the magi with their gifts from the east. The chaos of their journey from Nazareth and the finding of some sort of place to be for the moment of Jesus' birth must have tumbled around in Joseph's mind. The inadequacy of the feeding trough for a cradle and an animal shelter we call a stable, but actually more like a cave, must have gone round and round in his thinking. He did not have to go through labour and the pain of giving birth. His was the role of waiting. Being that is sometimes enough. He did not have to do this or that or go there. He just had to be. This Christmas time, just be there in the moment of the birth of Jesus. The angels sing out glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth peace. Hear that chorus in whatever musical style speaks to you. But be no longer deaf, for the glory of the Lord has surrounded you, and even though you have not done anything to merit it, he has come to you with his peace and his love, his light and his truth. The passive and the active can join with shepherds, glorifying and praising God. Don't just stand there. Oh, I'm not. I'm glorifying God. Why don't you sing along in your way with me? Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Unto us is born a son, King of glory above. See on earth his life begun, from God's Lord eternal. Christ from heaven descending low, comes on earth a stranger. Of sadness their own unknown, he cradled in the manger, he cradled in the manger.
This did heaven sore afraid, and grievously bewildered, so he gave the world to slay, and slew the little children, and slew the little children.
Of his love and mercy mild, this the Christmas story, and all that Mary's gentle child might lead us up to glory, might lead us up to glory.